With that, why don't we go ahead and start our opening remarks. Representative Manzullo, would you like to begin?
Thank you very much for the opportunity to be here. Let me introduce to you my wife, Frida. The issue is returning Americans to work. Let's go through about 5 points. First of all, when I talk to employers who are on the verge of hiring, they say because of the uncertainty, they simply do not want to hire. One employer told me just a few weeks ago, he said, sometimes I don't know if I want to hire or if I want to lay off because of the uncertainty over the following things. Number one, I don't know what my tax rate's going to be. Democrats during the House sent us home without Americans going greater taxes they would pay the next year. Second of all is Obamacare. Can't predict it. It's a bankrupt company. Third of all, the excessive spending is sucking out the money out of the private sector so that we don't have money to invest in our own company. Fourth of all, the banks are being pressured from the regulators so that the line of credit to expand the job simply is not there. Fifth of all, such things as the carbon tax, promises of new regulations all hurt job growth. And sixth of all, we have to have fair trade and free trade, work on trade laws that protect Americans against abuses such as currency manipulation.
Over the summer, Congress passed and President Obama signed a bill that sent $26 billion to the states. Proponents called it a necessary aid package. Opponents called a bailout of profligate states that didn't deserve it. Representative Manzullo, how did you vote on that bill, and what was your response to it?
I am the most conservative member of all 21 members of Congress from the state of Illinois. You can clap at that. I voted against it. It's the seventh of seven bailout stimuli bills, stimulus column, whatever you want. This one ostensibly was for public service workers, teachers, etc. And interestingly enough, very few school districts actually take that money that was allotted to them and quote save jobs. But you can't save jobs with money that's borrowed from the federal government and ends up being a tax and added to the national debt. Because the more debt you have, the more it hurts the recovery. So that's why I voted against it. That's why I voted against all the students.
All right, we'll move on to our next question, which I know is on the minds of many folks. Specifically, this comes from Nancy in Crystal Lake. How can we get rid of the health care law, and what should we do instead? And there was another individual who asked us, how was the process that brought us Obamacare, would you support it or repeal it, and how would you change it? So we'll start with you, Congressman Manzullo.
Well, I voted against it with my trained legal office. Pages. I've never seen so much arm twisting and outright. I can't use it as a puff. Where members of Congress exchange projects in their district for yes votes, they will pay the price because what is brought about the Tea Party is the fact that people want to be represented. There's nothing more disgusting than sending somebody to Washington who represents himself and the people who vote for them. But that's going to be very difficult because we want to have two-thirds majority, so we're going to starve to death in the appropriations process. And do that by not allowing people who do certain functions to get paid. It's very unique.
Mr. Walsh? The next question has to do with energy policy. We'll begin with you, Congressman Manzullo. This person asks, I was informed that cap and trade approved by Congress would cost a postage stamp a day for a family of four. Pennies on the dollar. Do you agree with this statement? And what does cap and trade mean for America?
East Dubuque, Illinois is at the far west end of our district. A place called Rentec makes anhydrous ammonia, urea, and other things for agricultural applications. Well, then Senator Obama in June of 2008 said that he would impose a carbon tax. $1 billion project fell on its face to convert that facility first in America using natural gas as a feedstock for fertilizer products to coal. It would have brought in 1,000 construction workers, started the natural green revolution across the top of the state. A carbon tax cost our congressional district hundreds, if not thousands, of jobs just by the mere fact of talking about it. It'll lose somewhere between 3 and 4 million jobs. To impose a carbon tax on us, while the Chinese say they're not going to be bound by it because they're an underdeveloped country, that is suicide. It is stupid to pass laws like that that hurt our manufacturers.
Question. How do we cut entitlements? From Nancy and Crystal Lake. Thank you, Congressman Manzullo.
The best way to ruin a government is to give people the idea that they have a right to something. What destroyed the housing is that which has caused this recession is people became convinced that they had a right to own a home, even if they could not afford it. Once it became a right, it then became an entitlement. That's the problem with the entitlement philosophy, so that has to turn around. But let me just take one of them on Medicare. The problem, I wish we had more time. The problem with the health care bill is the fact that it does not bend the curve of price increases for health care. That's why the Republicans valiantly pushed away from the table with the idea that we should have caps on large verdicts to protect the hospitals and the medical providers. Just look what they pay in Wisconsin, although that's been held unconstitutional now. So we have to take the opportunity to, number one, educate the American people that entitlement reform is absolutely necessary in order for us to have a sustainable economy. One that will balance the budget, and second of all, we have to take entitlement by entitlement, and some of them are going to have to be really taken to hard work in all the ways the whole country is in this
problem. We have a question from the audience that I'm actually able to answer. In the event that, since you're both running as Republicans, in the event that Republicans regain majorities in Congress, what will be the top issues that you will focus on? Congressman Manzullo?
There are three issues. It's jobs. The second issue is jobs. The third issue is jobs. Is the Democratic Congress and the White House have all tried to fix the problem as opposed to coming up with a cure for the problem. It doesn't do any good to have all these programs, stimulus programs, programs to help our people are losing their homes, et cetera, unless people can work. And once people go back to work, that restarts the chains of commerce. That gets things going, especially in the area of manufacturing. So we have to make it as easy as possible, as I stated in my opening statement, to get Americans back to work. In fact, on the counter in fact, this is Congressman Don Manzullo, an American jobs agenda. It's very specific on things that we have. But those are the three top priorities, and obviously, included with that, is cutting the massive spending.
Thank you, Mr. Walsh.
I'd only add to what...
On November 3rd, Americans are going to wake up and recognize our country. We are living a day when things have moved so quickly in the past 20 months that we don't recognize this country. I had the opportunity to study in Washington and write a book on the Establishment Clause of the First Amendment. The heroes out there have their names etched in stone. John Adams, Jefferson, Samuel Adams. America needs to again examine the founders' documents so it reminds us of who we are as a nation and the greatness that we have in our tradition. It makes us rise up and be proud of the fact that we are Americans. Somebody has to lead the world, and only America is going to do it.